Can I hear the church say praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord!
It is indeed a wonderful privilege to be in the presence of the Lord.
Amen.
I want to thank you, Brother Nick, for that musical piece, above all, power. God is more powerful than we think we are. Amen?
Amen.
And so we serve a mighty God.
Yes.
It's a joy for me to be here today. And every time I come to Jackson, it reminds me of home. So I still believe I understand very well.
Amen.
And that's a good feeling.
Amen.
Sometimes, let me tell you, I remember the first time I went away, it was like I want to come back home. Because I'm tired of up here now. I want to go back home. And the very day when I were planning to come back home, when I packed my suitcase, I feel good. But I never feel good till when I look and I see my sister who come to pick me up. I felt so good. I say all of this to say, Jesus is coming again.
Amen.
And we all will feel good when we know that we would have lived a life that is pleasing unto God. We would have beaten by the enemy. But here we are in the presence of the Lord today, on this holy Sabbath day. You can imagine when Jesus come and we hear the welcome word, enter into the joy. What a day that will be. I am telling you, over here at Jackson, prepare from now to make heaven your home. It won't be long, Bridget. And I can imagine some pains that you may be going through, some suffering that some of us would have been going through. But we all serve a mighty God, amen?
Amen?
And the fact that we are alive, it means that God is still in control.
Yes.
You see, as oftentimes I said, the alone never wake me up this morning. And even though I sleep beside my wife, she wasn't the one who waked me up this morning. But the hands of Jesus have waked me up this morning. I bring you greetings from the Standard Grove Church. And as I mentioned before, Brother Rowan Angus and Brother Kenan Hicks, I am happy to have two drivers who take me today to Jackson. What a God. And as I look around, I always admire Jackson, and I always look for some faces, and out of the faces that I normally see, I haven't seen one. I have seen Sister Mother James, I have seen Mother Donaldson, and I am not seeing Sister Bennett. Sister Bennett is my good friend. I see Brother Bennett at the back. But I haven't seen Sister Bennett, but I hope she's okay. I was in Macon yesterday when I got the news that Brother Blackwood is not so well. But Brother Blackwood, I know that you serve a mighty God. So if it was up for the devil, you wouldn't be here this morning. But God's grace and His mercy has carried you through. And as a result, I believe that you are happy to be in the presence of the Lord.
Yeah.
I am happy. I could stand here for the rest of the afternoon and tell you how happy I am. But let me tell you one thing. No dead person is in here this morning. If I should ask all the dead persons to stand, no one would stand. So we are here today to magnify the name of the Lord. We are here to praise the Lord. I don't know about you, but I didn't come here to have fun. I come here to worship and to praise the name of the Lord. Hence the psalmist David says, let everything that I've heard
praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. You see, I wake up this morning, and my wife makes sure that she gives me a healthy breakfast. She never gave me any bread sandwich this morning. She made sure that she gave me some nice cooked food to eat this morning. So I am strong. the second time I ever stand at the pulpit and my wife is not in the congregation. I remember I went to St. Anne to preach, and unfortunately she wasn't around. And today, because of the old health programming in our churches, she were asked to do something in divine worship today, so she's not here, but she's okay. As a virgin, I stand with her group is doing well. I remember we invite Evangelist Fitzhenry, many of us should know him, to preach at church. And just as he, for those of you who know Fitzhenry, he doesn't want to tell him to over church at X time. He's a long winter. And so this Sabbath in question, when he comes to Stanberry Grove and the choir sing the song of meditation, and just as he said, the rain came down. And he said, Lord have mercy, you are a good God. Because I don't want you to stop till 3 hours time. And just the virgin, the rain never stopped till 3 hours time. And he preached like 2.5 hours. And he used the other offering to make the appeal, so we went on in 3 hours time. It wasn't music day. It was a regular Sabbath day. But when I see the rain, I said, Lord, I am fixing the Jackson today. But unfortunately, I won't be preaching long today. I won't have you long today, but I will surely get you out here before Vespa this afternoon. And so today, as we open God's word, may I invite you to turn your hymnals to the hymn number 260, 260, as we prepare our heart for the word. Overheard me, Holy Spirit, we'll sing the first verse.